Hey everybody, welcome back. We'll do some random hard mode this time. Try to make some progress. Okay, we'll play as Isaac again, I guess. I threw so hard last time, but I think part of what I've learned... Hey, at least we get an extra item room without requiring a key, thanks to Curse of the Labyrinth. Part of what I've learned is, you know, maybe stay away. Just wrote down a seed there. You can see it for yourself. Maybe stay away from Dr. Fetus. Are we really going to fight Super Wrath, like, every run here? We killed him with one Fetus Bomb last time, which is also the number one wrestling move in Vancouver. You should check it out sometime. Get yourself a Fetus Bomb. Come down to Falls Creek, I'll give you a Fetus Bomb, brother! Alright. Well, I'm feeling a little bit more lively than I did in the last episode, maybe because I got no feline distractions, you know what I mean? That wasn't like a reference to the opposite sex, gentlemen. I just have cats that are kind of annoying. Mr. Omega. I didn't, baby. You just told me. This is a pretty good item for us. If only I could maybe put, like, Aquarius on this run and Mr. Mega on the last run, we might even be able to snag two victories out of one. But I like Mr. Mega because it gives you, like, a little ninja mask here as well. Dead Onion. I've gone on record, you know, I've used Dead Onion a lot. I don't think it's very good, but it does give you some extra damage. I think it lowers your range substantially. I like it enough. And I think it can synergize nicely with items like Proptosis, for example. So I don't necessarily mind picking it up here. Wow, these enemies are actually taking a lot of hits. Yeah, I think it's okay. It does no toxic damage, though. And that was what really irked me, is like, when I asked questions about this in earlier episodes, I was like, well, what it says toxic aura tiers, what's the toxic aura? People were like, nah, it's just bullshit. It's just like piercing shots, sort of, that are a little bit bigger. I guess that's what makes them have their aura, is that they're slightly larger. But anyway, I'll be just enjoying life here, probably taking like 80 hits to kill this champion. That's okay. Y'all want to crown me the champion? Something, something, suckers see it can't be done. Man, I need to re-listen to Wild Wild West if I'm going to quote it all the time. Gemini is another item that I think is actually pretty dang good. I'm going to be okay with this. It's like an attack fly that is actually a little bit homing. And I like attack flies, so an attack fly that has a little bit of a, you know, actual AI associated with it is pretty sweet as well. This is a good start for us. I really am. I'm embarrassed by the way that the last run ended. In my defense, we had Curse of the Unknown, and I don't think I've ever seen... There's a Tinted Rock there. I don't think I've ever seen a Tinted Rock either, but that's what some people would say. I had Curse of the Unknown, and I've never seen a fire rate that high with Fetus in a Jar, and it just caused all sorts of problems. But still, I should be better than that, you know? And I know I'm going to get a little bit of anger in the comments as a result. And honestly, this is one of the times that I feel I definitely maybe deserve that. Not to... you know, pure vitriol, but maybe a little bit of a remuneration. What am I trying to get here? I don't know. A rebuking. Maybe that's where I'm going with the RE. We're doing decent damage. Gemini's helping out a little bit. We're gonna stay the heck away from whatever's going on in that room. This is, you know, I feel like we're strong for this point in the game. I never really felt that on the last run. I felt like sometimes we were a little bit, we had some okay items, you know, the ability to fly plus the Fetus in a Jar, but still, never really felt like we were going to run away with the game at any point. I wonder how different that last run would have gone if we'd actually been able to take Brimstone instead of just sacrificing the HP to get maybe a damage bonus from it, but maybe not. We're being treated quite well with respect to our keys here. I'm very impressed. I didn't realize these were spectral tiers as well. Yeah, Curved Horn, great trinket for us. Alright, two boss fights in a row. Let's get ready to rumble. Larry Jr. is a very easy boss fight for us when we have piercing shots. If you don't have piercing shots, he's maybe not the easiest, but not too difficult either. Well, hard mode my butt. This is actually shaping up to be pretty easy so far. I really thought that hard mode was going to be like double damage for the entirety of the game, but seems like it's more of like an extra champions and less consumables type balance, which is, that's fine. Hopefully we can figure out how to navigate it. Saving my reroll, by the way, on that evil up back there, just in case we do want to use its item. Spirit Heart. Spiders, okay. Well, nothing special there. We're definitely going to take Coat Hanger. How do I feel about the evil upgrade? Like, it's evil up, so it gives you a black heart, plus, like, bombs. Is that it? I'm going to reroll it. Synth oil? Synth oil. I prefer that. Slightly increased range might benefit us kind of drastically. We can actually really use a shot speed up, which might have actually been included in matchbook, but hey, I think synth oil is an okay choice for us as well. Not gonna go to our secret room here, not gonna go to our shop, save our keys, ride a cowboy, head down to the next floor. We're in a pretty good position here. You know, nobody's gonna write a bunch of ballads about our incredible damage or anything like that. You know, we're no Edmund Fitzgerald right now. But that's okay. With piercing, or not piercing, but spectral shots, we don't even really have to get too close to these guys. Really hoping to find just kind of like a random black market at some point. Hasn't happened yet, but that doesn't mean it won't happen ever. You know what would be sweet? It was if you could pick up multiple Geminis per run, but every Gemini you picked up, like almost like a cube of meat, I guess, but it would be rarer, I suppose, which is kind of dangerous in this situation because, you know, cube of meat never shows up as is. But every Gemini you picked up, like, added 30% to the length of the Gemini cord or something like that. So if you got three, it would, like, actually home in on enemies across the room. Balls of steel. Just spitballing here. That could be fun. I really don't like the fact that we're all the way across the map now, because I was looking forward to opening that golden chest. Now, keys are usually, you know, fairly hard to come by, supposedly, on these hard mode runs. So I don't love the idea of getting rid of keys on golden chests, but we kind of have a surplus right now. But as of right now, we actually have the perfect opportunity as well to fight our boss. Gemini is going to be able to stay in range. That was terrible damage. We should have a very good chance of getting a deal with the devil and or angel. I don't know which one it'll actually be, because I want deals with the devil. But the last deal with the devil didn't give us... Oh, so bad. Didn't give us anything. So we might just not get anything. Oh, yeah, we didn't. Two spirit arts. Let's reroll little Steven. That's like a tears plus shot speed up, so I'll take it. Normally, a torn photo might be considered a little not great. But the shot speed up actually helps us, because if I'm moving with the slow shot speed that I had on that last room... Could have been worse, I guess. If I'm moving forward in the same direction that I'm shooting, with the shot speed that we used to have, could cause me some serious problems, because I could reach my target before the bullets do, which is no good. That was well worth it. Almost enough money to make our shop worthwhile. This run's shaping up to be pretty okay. If I do say so myself. Maybe erase the terribleness of the last run. Remove that from my mind at my earliest convenience. I don't know if Little Steven is going to be a rerollable item. Like my whole... Like if my meta is going to designate that as a rerollable item forever. But we'll see. I hope our secret room allows us to access this. Because, like, the thing is, I have almost a hard and fast rule, which is, like, if you get damage upgrades, you don't reroll them. Little Steven is sort of a damage upgrade. He gives you more DPS. But I think that's kind of a loose definition, because if, like, Brother Bobby showed up... Wow, that's 16 cents. If Brother Bobby showed up, would I be saying, well, Brother Bobby's a DPS upgrade? No, I'd be saying, Brother Bobby's shitty, let's reroll him and hope to get Mom's knife. So maybe I should accept the fact that Little Steven is not necessarily as good as I think it is. I think Little Steven is kind of like Ghostbusters 2. It's overrated. Don't give me that shit. If you think... I love number one. I can't tell a lie. There is a tinted rock here, by the way. If you think Ghostbusters 2 is good, that's fine. I don't have a problem with you. If you think Ghostbusters 2 is better than Ghostbusters 1, you're gonna have to have a talk with your mother and I. I'm gonna take number one, even though it lowers our range. People get so mad at me when I take number one, and I don't care because I think it's a pretty fun item. The extra rate of fire is just silly, which I like. And, you know, range upgrades fairly easy to come by. We've got theirs options now, which means that on our remaining however many boss fights, what are we at, Catacombs 1, on our next two boss fights, we'll at least have a choice, and it kind of doubles the effectiveness of our rerolls as well. So I'm content to have the situation that we got going on here. I'm feeling pretty good about it. I need someone like Snaps to like weigh in on number one. I think he likes it because he likes, you know, Skinny Odd Mushroom, which is a damage downgrade and increased rate of fire. Seems like a range downgrade plus increased rate of fire would also be up his alley. But that's, I just need a column that's like, you know, ask Snaps, and then we go, hey Bisnap, how do you feel about number one? And he goes, I'm for it. And then you say, okay, thank you. I appreciate that because I can't be trusted. That's really lucky. I can't be trusted to make decisions on my own. We are doing like pretty crazy damage, and you know what? Having a range downgrade might be bad in a lot of cases, but if you have Gemini, it's almost like an incentive to just get closer, which is dangerous on a room like this, but otherwise maybe fairly beneficial. Well, there's a Tinted Rock, but we can't get to it yet. This is an interesting kind of corridor for us. Let's see what we've got in our item room. It's controllable fly, and that is shielded tears. Okay, or not. Oh, I get it wrong every time. I think Nearsighted Friend is pretty terrible, but controllable familiar, I think, is kind of bad. I've gone full circle on it. I used to think it was really cool, but there's never a situation, or at least very rarely a situation, where I've found it out how to use it effectively. In theory, I can come up with all sorts of situations, you know, you just put it, like, on top of the enemy, and then never touch it again, but then you can't fire. You literally just can't fire. And actually, this is one of the rooms where maybe it would be very worthwhile for us to have that. Because it appears like we just can't actually hit our enemies. Oh, there we go, we got one. You just gotta give it, like, a serious bit of momentum here. You gotta get up to, like, top speed. Which is hard when they're shooting at you as well. There we go, just one left. Kinda wanna approach it at an angle here. There we go. Well, hopefully we don't encounter too many more rooms like that. That could actually conceivably end our run. But I'm assuming, and by assuming I mean, you know, hoping that we end up getting the ability to fly from our, well, let's assume, because it's gonna happen for sure, that we fight the Fallen here. The Fallen gives us, like, Lord of the Pit. And then we get a deal with the devil that just gives us, like, brimstone or something. The end. I'll do it. I know it's... Wow, I can't believe that was the first time we took damage there. We'll take Squeezy here. Extra tears, which might not be that effective, but still, the spirit arts are nice. And we're gonna be fighting Krampus, which means we will have a reroll available. If he gives me Krampus's head, we'll definitely reroll it. Question is, what if he gives us a lump of coal? Which he didn't, so we can just reroll it. Guilt-free, that feels good. That becomes Guppy's Collar. Which again, I like it, gives us a chance to become Guppy. Not very much strategic benefit to this item, I think. Honestly, I think we're just gonna head down to the next floor. I know we didn't go to our shop, we don't have the money necessary to make it work, and I don't think I'm likely to find the secret room as a result of the fact that I have Curse of the Lost. If I didn't have Curse of the Lost, I'd probably explore a little bit more. Curse of the Labyrinth, alright, so this is gonna be our last two item rooms and then two boss rooms. You should never do what I did there. Just, whenever that room starts, just stay down at the freaking bottom and you'll be fine. But I always have to try to be Stephen the fucking Queen or something like that. It's a ridiculous reference because I don't think I've ever seen a Steve McQueen movie in my life. I just know that he is universally regarded as a quote-unquote cool dude. I know, and you're gonna say how you're gonna talk shit about movies like Grandma's Boy, but you've never seen classic pieces of American cinema like The Great Escape or Bullet? And the answer to that question is yes. That is the truth. But I still know what I'm talking about when it comes to Ghostbusters 2. Ghostbusters 2 is, it's okay. But whenever people are like, yeah, man, Ghostbusters 1's alright, but, you know, Viggo the Carpathian. I agree with Nick. He's like, the dude's in the movie for like 10 seconds. Who cares? It's Pisces, like tears plus knockback. I like it. You know, another tears upgrade might not help that much, but it doesn't hurt. And actually, knockback with low range seems to be kind of a nice combination. You know, keep these enemies away from me. Knockback can be, you know, your greatest friend or your greatest enemy. But here, I think it's a relatively okay choice. All right, you know what, you dang savages? I'll shoot the fire here. Person that I just made up in my head, who was telling me to shoot the fire, and I was hesitant to the idea. Maybe you might want to blow up those fires and have a decent chance to get a spirit heart. I could absolutely understand the argument for that cause. I'm not going to do it because you never know. Maybe our bombs are going to be more precious than that. I find my brain getting like some weird dissociation. Disassociation? Whatever. I find my brain getting all funky-like when I get tears that are big and also shoot quickly. Like, my brain just kind of lets go. It says, you know what? Something's gonna happen here, and you do have a little bit, you have a modicum of control over it, but I can't nearly follow all of these projectiles on the screen. So my brain kind of goes into like a I don't know, like, standby. And it's just like, I can only basically give you the big picture, Ryan. I know you would love to know exactly where these projectiles are going to land and how that's going to work, and then calculate how much damage you think they do and when enemies are going to die, but I can't provide that for you in light of these extreme circumstances. So instead, can you guys hear this shit in the background? It's getting a little unbelievable, like an EMF song, if you know what I mean. Which many people probably don't until they look it up on Wikipedia, because people are like, who the fuck is EMF? Thank you! Thank you is actually a Dido song. Anyway. Why would you make your name so close to Dildo? I mean, it worked out for her, right? But the jokes make themselves. I know that Dido is it's a reference to, like, Greek literature as well, or Greek mythology. I'm not sure which one. Not that there's necessarily, they can't be the same thing in some situations, but still, you know, we live in the modern era. If you name yourself Dido, people are gonna say more like Dildo. You just gotta know that. Don't name your kid Dido, okay? Well, you know, fuck me, you can do whatever you want. But if you name your kid Dido, people are gonna call them Dildo. So at least, you know, recognize that. I rerolled Rosary. Yeah, that's right, I did it. Who do you think you are? I am. Seriously, though, Rosary's alright. Especially towards, like, the end of my time with Vanilla, I was getting down with Rosary. I was like, this item, I've been looking down on this item for years. But it's actually pretty solid. The three spirit arts make a big difference, and if you get a lot of rerolls, it don't matter if the Bible shows up, because you just reroll it. That being said, I think in our current situation, hey, good to know it exists. In our current situation, it's actually pretty bad. We're gonna go to the shop. I would like to reroll the coin purse, I think. Yeah, I'd like to reroll the coin purse. Have we really gotten anything from pills that have been that exciting? What's going on here? Oh, okay. Invisible ones of you. We've gotten, like, a full health pill. That might be nice to have in the future. Remote detonator is not very good. We're not going to use our money for anything else, so if we have to, we might as well pick up Remote Detonator just to get the bombs. Or we could donate to the donation machine, that's the other thing. We're still grinding out money here, too. These shots will hit, you just gotta, you know, you gotta believe a little bit. There you go, just give it a little bit of forward momentum, that'll sort it right out. We're going to explore a little bit more because our rerolls actually are pretty important to us. It's the other thing is that if we reroll into, like a 9-volt or something like that, we also get a reroll that we can use on our, Mom's Bra, which is an item that, although okay, is not really going to benefit us too much in our present circumstances. I guess we might as well fight, like, our first boss. Give us an extra item that we can use in the future of the rest of this floor. That will put us one room shy of having a reroll, though. It's a big floor, but we've already been to, presumably, all the special rooms. And honestly, I think we've done fairly well for ourselves on this run. So we're fighting war. That's one orbital, which is all you ever get if you're going for these bandages and meats, boys. So many people tweeted me, and they're like, man, I don't know what you're talking about. I got third level meat boy on, like, my second run. Which is not ridiculous. Like, that's probably not even possible, because you don't even have the horsemen by that point. We'll take... Yeah. We'll take our damage upgrade here instead. But... I believe those people, by the way. But still, man, it's so not easy to get... the meatses anymore. We're gonna go to this, like, last room. Is that really our last room? Let's see if there's a secret room here. It just looked nice, and it ended up being correct. And actually, I'm super psyched to be fighting Greed. Maybe you can give me, like, a steam sale or a quarter or something. Or just a stupid amount of cashish. Alright. I hate myself every time I say cashish, but I think what I hate most about it is that the fact that I don't hate it, not even a little, not even at all. Now, this run, I mean, it hasn't been... I had a feeling lightning couldn't strike twice there. This run hasn't been that incredible, but we're still going to get an opportunity at the boss rush room, which is ridiculous. So I think we buy this just to get the extra bombs, and then we say, you know, fudge you, Tony, and then we reroll it. Becomes the boomerang, which is not good for us. And there's no battery for sale, which sucks pretty hard. There you go. So we'll buy a spirit heart. I think we'll buy another key as well. Not that we're going to get a big opportunity to use it, probably, but hey. So we've got to remember, at the very least, aim to beat Mom's heart here. Because it gives you an unlock. which I did not get from the last. I was like, well, as long as I beat Mom, I'll get an unlock. Not true, said the game. And then my embarrassing, like, failure on that last run became even more embarrassing by my, you know, the revelation that I was completely ignorant of the concepts of hard mode. It's okay, though. Well, part of the process of this is me learning. So we'll take this. Is there anything worthwhile in here? So one of these is Cursed Eye, Little Haunt, Celtic Cross, and Infamy. I think they're honestly not good enough. Cursed Eye with our rate of fire is just a death wish. Infamy often pops up by itself anyway, and I don't value it that highly. No offense to you, Infamy. What else was in there? Little Haunt? Little Haunt is okay, but at the same time, is it worth, you know, probably spending a lot of time on that boss rush room and maybe dying in the process, or maybe losing our spirit hearts at least in the process? Might have gained more spirit hearts, you know. That's what I do suggest does happen sometimes. I don't think it's that worthwhile. It's not the best familiar in the game, even though it is pretty okay. And what was the other one? Celtic Cross. Celtic Cross is like, again, it's fine, but it's not kind of like game-winning enough for me to really love the idea of putting myself through the boss rush to get it. Mostly because, you know, if you're not doing a stupid amount of damage, boss rush is just kind of tedious. And I think people can relate to that. Boss rush is one of those things, like, it's a super cool addition to the game, but at the same time, after you've done it like 50 times, you're like, you know what? You gotta give me a pretty damn good reason to do boss rush mode, for me at least, because I am not, this is not something like I want to spend my time doing every time. It's more of like a cool Easter egg. Cool Ethan egg. Let's move along here. Actually, you know what we will, I earlier said there's options will only give us options for like the next two boss fights, but that's not true. Because, ooh, careful. We actually have another opportunity to use theirs options like right here on this boss fight. Sometimes I assume, you know, all the bounty of items end when you start, oh, that was so bad, when you go down to the womb, but that's not true. That was a beautiful animation there, by the way. I didn't have my immersion broken at all. Oh, okay. Ruka, it's okay, buddy. Don't worry about it. How do these cats freaking survive when we are asleep? We sleep for 8 hours, we wake up and they're fine, but then, you know, I close my door and you can hear me talking and they're like, what the fuck is he talking about us? Let me in there, I can help you out. I'll play co-op with you. That would actually be, there's your 1 million subscriber special, if it happens. I'll try to play The Binding of Isaac Rebirth with Ruka and Tomo. And we'll run some very strict scientific analysis and see which cat is better. I think they're both going to be pretty terrible. Skolix. Now, not too ornery about this. We're doing decent damage and, you know, our shots are penetrative and shouldn't be too bad. Hoping that with theirs options, we just get something good right off the bat and then hopefully like a deal with the devil afterwards that we can reroll into something beautiful. I would really, really prefer to be able to enter my deal with the devil without picking up one of these items. Since we can't, I think I will take the screw for the... I'll take the HP. And then we can become Guppy, because we already have the collar. So that's pretty big. We have low HP, though. Very, very low HP. So we'll reroll both of these, and we get Pentagram for free. And we could roll with 9 lives, but I think that's kind of a silly choice. I like how the horns kind of fit perfectly into our ears, by the way. That's cool. And I mean this sincerely, this is not a one run. We need more HP. Oh, we can't get back to our deal with the devil. That's fine. I wasn't expecting to, but I was like, you know, if we get that battery, we can reroll and maybe get something good. So our damage should be out of control right now. And we can fly, so we've got good defensive abilities, good offensive capabilities. You never know what can work out for us here. And if we end up getting a bunch of red hearts, we can do like our devil judgment or demon judgment. Boss trap room chain here, you know, just your standard combination. This cat, man, I feel bad because I know that like a cat's, it's like a baby, right? It's like, why is your door closed? Don't you love me? And I'm like, well, I do love you, just please be quiet. Which is a terrible thing to say, but the cat doesn't get it, you know. I'm just gonna get back to full health for now. You know, we can't treat that health as as a bonus if we actually need it to get back to full health. Every red heart that drops from this point on until I take damage, though, we can talk about. Are you a wizard? Not very good for us. I don't know why I picked up the second one. I guess I'm just a glutton for punishment. Now, we could wait it out, but at the same time, I kind of think it doesn't matter. I'll take my punishment on the chin here. Come on, flies. Work with me here. Our flies do a ton of damage, by the way. I'm loving that. When, you know, when Fred Durst said, "Now I know y'all be loving this shit right here," he was talking about, you know, the damage that you do from guppy flies. Most people don't realize that because he's just like, he's basically the Nostradamus of our generation. He's actually the Nostradamus of Nostradamus's generation, too. He's actually a time-traveling savant. Yeah, there's a decent amount of HP there. The question is, do I really want to go fight in the boss rush room if it could possibly kill me? And the answer to that question is fudge no, Tony. Where did you come from? Honestly, I think we're just going to be not so cheeky, and we're going to say, hey, let's go fight Mom's Heart right now and at least get our, you know, our progress. That was a very bad start, by the way. We've really got to work hard to take less damage in the future. We're going to get hit, and we're probably going to die here. But Guppy's Collar could bring us back. Oh, God. Flies, work with me here. Oh, we did it. We did it. We did it. We did it. You unlocked Lost Baby. At least we did, at least we unlocked something on this run. So I can feel good about that. Honestly, I don't think our chances of winning on, do we have more back here, by the way? Maybe, maybe not. Maybe not. Trying to find a secret room. I don't think our chances of beating Isaac are that bad. Our chances of beating Blue Baby are probably pretty low. By virtue of the fact that we only have one key right now. That's a problem. This floor's got a little bit more gold to mine. Like, quite literally, apparently. But also, we can go check this out in here. Oh, three... I'll leave, please. Three red chests actually titillates me in the old titillation zone. I think there's some decent potential for greatness there. Maybe even a teleportation to a deal with the devil that wouldn't make sense at all. I say we do it because we got HP. That's a bad start. But the bosses we're fighting shouldn't be that difficult. I mean, yeah, the fistulas are already dead. We picked up a little HP that is not really worthwhile for us. That's okay. Maybe another few spirit... Even if we get one spirit heart out of this, I would feel so thankful. Oh, we're also... We'll get back to the half-heart interval, which is good. There's one spirit heart. And balls of steel, so that's three spirit hearts. And then bombs are key, which is great, because now we can actually stand a chance of opening up the chest. I know what you're thinking. We should play that Demon Judgment, but I don't think that is a very smart idea for us right now. I think we should probably not count our chickens yet. But there's another unlock, so at least we got something happening on this run. I'm liking it, I'm loving it, I want some more oven it. I don't really want to talk about what just happened. That's me being an idiot yet again. But what I will say is that you do still need an unlock for beating Satan. Man, I will take Samson's Chain. I am disappointed with myself. I cannot tell a lie. Two kind of enormo throws today. In my defense, Man, there's nothing I can offer in my own defense. I'm just going to eat that shit on the chin. I'm sorry. It punishes me as much as it punishes you, because now I've got to have an... Seriously, you're going to just force me to take Bob's Rotten Head? Now I've got to have another run, like, equivalent or better to this damage in order to actually, you know, do what needed to be done. We had a really good chance of beating Isaac and maybe even the chest on this one. But, I guess we'll have to settle for beating Satan on a hard mode, which, I mean, it feels nice, but also I'm a big dummy. I really can't offer anything in my own defense here, except that I was moving real darn quickly. It is a dang shame, is what it is. I apologize for using strong language, but it is a dang shame. Spider Baby's pretty good as well. Is there any way out of this for us? Like, I didn't take the negative. I took the Polaroid. I'm 99% sure about that. I don't think there is any way out of this, unless we get like an IM error room or something like that. Which I don't even know how that would happen. Well, we'll, you know, get ready to fight the boss, I guess. We should be able to steamroll Satan super duper easily. With Samson's Chain, we can check out, you know, all these rocks. Speed plus the ability to fly plus Samson's Chain is a pretty good recipe for rocks not standing like a fucking chance. How many times are we gonna take damage on that room right there? Wouldn't be a Northern Lion series without a throw of that magnitude. Might as well open that. Hey, Trickle Charge. Not as good as Curved Horn, but a pretty good trinket in almost every other circumstance. Okay, good stuff. Let's do it.
Stay still.
This should be pretty easy. Both Fallens already dead. I don't even think we used like any spiders at all to make that happen. Any flies, I should say. Then second Satan died even faster than the Satan that preceded him. That was not a good way to do that on my part. And that was an even worse way, but hey, we're done. And we did not get another unlock for that. So I'm basically just a big ol' idiot. Did we at least get a little further progress? We're up to 320 items. I think we might have been there to begin with. But hey, thanks for watching, even though I'm an idiot. If you enjoyed it, click the like button. It helps out a great deal. And of course, subscribe if you want to see more in the future. But for now, thanks for watching, and I'll see you next time.